I don't think I remember getting any items from Episode Gladiolus. I might just go back and play the whole thing after I beat Core. Let me go ahead and get a watch on my chat by opening it up. I'm also gonna open. I don't need to play music because the music on here is already amazing. I'm not looking forward to listening to any haters. Yeah, whatever, you could shove off. Nice to know you got my cock in your mouth. Hit the dashboard. Dashboard's where I can see my chat. Or maybe video manager. Give me a minute. Yeah, nice. God damn it, why are people sending me this shit? Stop. Yeah, I seen it. I check my emails all the time. Alright, who wants to...
What the heck is that JonTron thing?
What JonTron thing?
Like reacting to like priority or something. Checking like priority or whatever.
Oh, JonTron said some pretty racial things. About how he said most of the majority of black people commit more crimes and that's why people are mad at him, which I can understand that. That is kind of, first of all, because he's looking at incarceration rates. That's incarceration. That's not actual, you know, anything else. You know, he's, yeah, but that's what he said, and that's why people are giving him shit for, which, you know, I'm sorry, but you put it out there, you know. You gotta be careful. I mean, I'm not saying you have to be total PC, but just be careful what you say. You know.
Congratulations, Gladio. You accomplished that which I couldn't. Care to show this failure how it's done? First the Blade Master, and then the Immortal.
Well, yeah, I don't think he should get himself like fired or blocked off YouTube for that stuff. But you're gonna get your ass blasted saying stuff like that. Because understand me why that's offensive. There's a difference between, you know, that and how Ghost in the Shell's, you know, whitewashed. There's a huge difference. You're really putting up people under the bus. And I know, I sometimes...
Tonight, my king of the night.
And I know sometimes I get to that when I make my little rants about females, but it's not like saying all if I would have said all females were whores, then, you know...
No, Devin.
Yeah, you just gotta be very careful. Oh, that's how you heal up. You block his attacks. Okay.
Did you have a good birthday?
I never got too much into it. I just know who he is. You know. I don't watch Game Grumps. I just know who he is because, you know, everybody else knows. It's one of those things, people know who you are type of thing. It's like with this with PewDiePie. You just can't help but know who PewDiePie is on the fact that he's PewDiePie.
I mean, I actually watch a lot of PewDiePie videos. A lot of them are funny.
Well, I'm just saying that it's like one of those things with JonTron. JonTron's...
The whole thing about him being Nazi,
I don't really think he is. I just think he just don't got a good grasp of what he just said. I don't think he understands that people aren't going to like what he said. I think that's what it is. He's more, I'd say, misunderstood. And even if you do believe that stuff, I wouldn't go vocalize it, you know.
in that one video.
Yeah. But it's kind of the same thing to say, you know, all white people are racist and horrible people.
Yo, Vincent, but how are you doing?
You know, it's like saying the same thing with white people are all racist. It's like, I just wouldn't say that. That's all I'm saying. I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't use that thing on. It's the same way. I just, you know, just don't use it. Just don't say that stuff. That's all there is to it.
I mean, all the people that are hating on him are literally just dumb because they don't understand. They get the concept of this video.
Oh, you mean the people talking to Michael Alex? The PewDiePie there, they took that out of context. That was out of context. I agree with that. That is out of context.
He even said sorry after he saw it in the video.
Oh, yeah, well, no, I don't understand that. But the Jontron thing, I kind of understood that. I understand why the upset of the Jontron, because, like, even though if you had those views, it's just like, be careful. I'm sorry, because the way I see it is...
I liked your video about YouTube. You are exactly right.
You just got to be careful. Businesses are watching YouTube all the time. And, you know, even smaller YouTubers like me, you know... There's some things you just... Now, I agree with you on the whole PewDiePie thing. I don't think PewDiePie should have got slammed. Because he was just, you know... It was a context thing for that.
Not on my watch.
I think it was Disney. He had a contract with Disney.
Okay. You gotta fight for it.
How can I let this happen? Try again when you're truly ready. Oh. I will.
Right.
They're like 200 sub channel isn't getting popular fast.
Oh yeah, no, the PewDiePie thing was just outrageous.
Like, a lot of his people that hate him are like 12-year-old kids that have like special needs. And I know that's messed up to say, but if you watch like a lot of his videos where he's like reacting to people who are hating on him, it's literally...
No, yeah. No, that situation's different, though. I'm just telling you, that's different than what Jontron did. Jontron knew what the fuck he was saying. He knew. He knew. I mean, I know sometimes people want to get controversy and want to be edgelords, but don't get mad if a company turns you down for that shit, you know? You could be an edgelord all you want. It's just, you're going to be turned out. It's like, it'd be like me going to a job interview and I call, let's see, I say to the manager, "What's up, my nigga? I ain't going to get the job." You know, I ain't going to get the job. You know, I ain't going to get the job because of that stuff. I ain't going to get it. It's just, you know, that was just, you know, when you do stuff like that, that's when people, you know, I'm sorry, but, you know, you're going to lose... You know, in the business field, you have to be more professional, and understandably so, because they want to appeal to all kinds of people, not just only one person that's on
the job.
You know, they don't want to just put on one Democrat. They want to make sure they can get everybody. So they don't want. That's why most jobs tell you not to talk about politics, because, understandably so, because it's dividing. You know, people aren't going to always be on the same side about things. You know, so it's best not to discuss that at work. Even if you, let's just say you believe strongly in abortion, you know, let's just say you believe strongly in abortion, I wouldn't go to your work and say that stuff, because, well, then you're gonna make the you're gonna have to put a hard position on your employers. Jontron's allowed to have the views he wants to have. But it's the fact he just went there vocalizing and then get mad that people want to take him off his contract. Unlike PewDiePie, it looked like he was saying it for real. Like, he was for real with all the shit he was saying, you know. And then Jontron said, like, we got to save all the white people from, you know, white genocide and all that stuff. And it's like, yeah, I would not say that. Yeah, you can have that opinion in your head, but I wouldn't go publicly with that. I wouldn't go public. It's the same thing with social justice warriors going around saying all white people need to die and all that stuff. It's just don't. If you know it's a bad idea, just don't do it. Just don't.
Yes.
He traversed these caves some 30 years ago. Turning a deaf ear to our wails and wishes, he proceeded unfazed, eyes ever forward. Yet he proved powerless before the general, cast out in defeat.
And with YouTube nowadays, you really gotta watch what you say. I don't know if you know this, but YouTube's putting a censorship program on here. So anything that can be misconstrued as misogynistic, sexist, and racist, well, I don't know what to tell you. You accidentally say something wrong. Let's just say, okay, if I were to say RNA is hot and I want to motor both those breasts, I could get removed technically for saying that because that's too feminist, misogynistic. And they can do that now. YouTube has allowed them to do that. Because do you remember the YouTube, was it Helper or YouTube Hero Program?
Because one aspiring to the role of King's Shield can stake his life for none but his liege. Not even for himself.
You know what that's about?
Yeah.
It's about, it was actually for social justice warriors. If a social justice warrior saw that your video was too offensive in some way or any context, they have the right to flag your videos down. And then they get a reward from YouTube, which I think is fucked up.
No, I won't.
But hey, you gotta watch what you say on that YouTube now. It's like, I don't know what to say.
Just like your father warned me. Once you set foot through that door,
Dan
no
Vincent, how
back.
You deal with the SJWs that come to your DMs and stuff?
One false step.
Well, you can't do anything about that. YouTube's got that shit on lockdown now. They got their shit on lockdown. You just better watch your mouth, and that's it. That's all you could do. So that means no smashing past videos, unfortunately. No talking about politics. It goes from a wide variety thing. If a female character's hot, you better not talk about hitting that cocoa butter lotion because that's sexist and degrades women. It's really stupid, to be quite honest. You know, there's a difference between free speech and hate speech, and unfortunately,
it sucks. I like when you share your views and stuff.
Well, you can't do it no more. No, they ain't gonna allow that shit. They're gonna censor that shit. Everything's censored. In fact, I could probably get marked down for cussing on stream. Really dumb. You know, it's ridiculous.
What is he streaming?
Oh, he streams a lot of games. He usually plays the stuff that, you know, he plays like most of the new stuff.
Dang, you can't even say you gonna go get the Jerkins bottle.
He works at Quintiles.
I know he used to be a manager at GameStop.
Yeah.
GameStop is like a horrible company.
Oh, it is. Me and James made a rant, huge rant about in the car. They messed him up too. Ain't surprised. So you know what I'm gonna do when the Final Fantasy VII remake comes up? I'll either order from Square Enix or I'll ask James to pre-order it when he, you know, he can't, cause he can't do pre-orders at a store, but he could do orders. So I'll probably get myself a collector's edition. Yeah, I'll have to pay $200, but at least it's not through GameStop, cause I'm not giving GameStop none of my business. I'm not, not ever. I think I need to play Score Attack after this. I just want to fight Gilgamesh again. See if I get anything.
Look how you try. I'm afraid of you.
Hey, the more you fight Gilgamesh, the easier he becomes. What's up with that?
Try this.
GameStop is evil. Emoji pouting face.
Oh yeah, they are. Oh yeah, they're corrupt. They're corrupt.
Countless disappointments in the around here.
It is. See, and people, when said censoring people on the internet, shouldn't we be fighting against GameStop? and companies that believe in that kind of policy, that's what we should be offended about. The way I see it, it's offensive what they do to their customers.
Every time I go to GameStop to pick something up, do you want to subscribe to this magazine? Do you want to pre-order
Free Zero
Games?
Oh my god, yeah, they do that all the time. They aggressively push that. No, you're right about that. They aggressively push that. You know how much Game Informer magazines I have? I got up to 112 Game Informer magazines. You know what? Come to think of it, I could get me a frame and put all those Game Informer magazines and have it in the background. Did not think of that, because I don't read every single one of them. It'd just be good for background.
You are strong, yet so long as fear binds your heart, the power you possess is wasted on you.
Yeah, I think I need to play Score Attack to get items. I don't think you can play the original one to get any items. I think in order to get the Gladiolus thing, you have to play Score Attack. So after I get done with this fight, I'm gonna go play Score Attack. I mean, there's two ways to do it. I'm pretty sure you don't have to just like fight Core. I think to fight Core, you have to be an advanced level, and they don't give you your level. I wish they would make my Gladiolus the same level as I have in the game. They only make him level 46. Oh yeah, well, because it's the part of the game it is. This is after Gladiolus got beat by Ravus. And you know, that's when, you know, that's like... I think that's chapter 6? I can't remember what chapter it was. But it's an earlier chapter. It's the first time you actually see him appear when you try to get your car back. Yeah, the Niflheim Empire took the car. After you get Rama, you have to go to that Niflheim Empire base and take the car right back. And then you see Ravus walking towards you, getting ready to fight you. And then Arden stops the battle. I'm gonna try Score Attack after this. I wonder if I could still play the special if they didn't get rid of the special. I like
what's
to be
up, homie?
What's up? You know what? I think I might play the special after all this. After I do my Score Attack, I think I might play the special, because then it would lead up perfectly. I think the reason they gave that free Niflheim Empire Chapter 13 special is just to add to it. Of course, well, I can't wait for his chapter prompt, though. That's what I'm really hoping for. That one is the one I need to see.
Hey bud, what are you up to?
Well, that was easy. I just beat Gilgamesh.
I kneel before no man.
Not exactly the souvenir I had in mind. It took me a while, but I realized something. You're right. I am afraid.
Yeah, I already know what happens. I don't think you get the sword until after Score Attack or the costume, so I gotta play Score Attack after this. After I play Score Attack, then I'll go play the special, then you'll go together perfectly. I never knew I was gonna stream this episode again.
What do you think?
Yeah, time to play some Score Attack. Yeah, I already. Yeah, I don't need to do that. I'll just go play some Score Attack. I think I'll up the level next time. This Gilgamesh was too easy. Alright, Score Attack. I think this is where you earn items at, is the Score Attack. Because what I'm seeing is the episode itself is just a story, and only that. I think the Score Attack, you earn items, but it's only specific to Gladiolus. I don't know what they're going to do with Episode Prompto, but it looks like you're going to be in like the Glacia, the frozen area.
Hey, what was that multiplayer thing you were talking about? 15 million.
They're working on a multiplayer package that you can play. I think it's mostly going to be hunts on multiplayer. I mean, I don't know what it's going to be like. And they said they're going to make a character creation where you can create your own character. But I think the reason they're not going to do that is because there's already a Final Fantasy game where you can create your own character. It's called Mobius. They need to put it into consoles and quit leaving it on the PC. I'd like to be able to play Mobius. Pretty much Mobius is like Dragon Ball Xenoverse, but with Final Fantasy Universe. But yes, I don't know what's going to happen. I know the Arden thing is going to be official, where you get to play episode Arden. That's going to be available too. Well, I wouldn't mind playing that, because I'd like to see what Arden can do. You know, what we need is episode Ravis. I'd like to be able to play as Ravis. And episode Aranea. Alright, we're going to play some Score Attack then. Score Attack it is. Let's do it. But if you play Dark Souls games, episode Gladiolus is pretty easy for you. I don't know what the multiplayer online is going to actually be like. I mean, I can't imagine how it would be like. Except probably going on quests and hunting down monsters. And the only old enemy they're going to put in Final Fantasy 15 was Gilgamesh, because Ultros was in Kingsglaive, so they didn't want to repeat that again. I wonder if they could put Typhoon next. Or maybe the rest of the weapons. That'd be nice. I mean, it'd be hard, but I like to fight the rest of the weapons, besides just Diamond Weapon. Because Diamond Weapon was the only one we saw in 15. Well, in Kingsglaive. Like, I want to fight Emerald Weapon again, Ruby Weapon. And it gets so hard, you would have to have the Knights of the Round Astral and summon the previous Kings of Lucius to beat them.
Try this!
Now this one, you don't even have Core helping you. So I notice the difference. I think I'll be fine if I can beat that serpent. Alright, I think I know what's coming next. It's probably that new form of the Red Giants. I hate those form. That new form. Okay, I can wipe these things out pretty easy. They're smaller enemies. As long as they don't all gather up and attack me at once, of course. I'm trying to save that maelstrom because I know that's the next thing I have to fight. What's over there? I want to see what's over there. No items, no potions, no nothing. Huh, interesting. Alright, I know what this one is. Yep, it is. I think it is what I think it is. Nope, not yet. It's after the Reaper. Oh, two Reapers, okay. Go next. I know what it is next. I know I have to fight next. But nope. Okay, those things. Versus Core. I think what I'm just going to do is do score attack to see what I earn, because I don't think I've played score attack. You're really supposed to...
in general, for the DLC, do you get the bigness review or faster or anything?
Oh, no. Now it gets core. You usually get core in the regular story, though.
And then I can make DLC.
Oh, an episode prompto, you mean?
In Gladiators.
Oh, you get core. Yeah, you get core to help you. Yeah, you get core. Which he's pretty good because he's strong. I'm telling you, he's really strong.
Isn't core like, can we use his bodyguard?
He was one of them. He was actually one of them. He left the Crown City before the events of Kingsglaive, so he couldn't. But he does. He's pretty much like one of King Regis's bodyguards, and he teaches Noctis every. He teaches Noctis how to fight and everything. I mean, a little bit after Kingsglaive. Yeah, that's who Kor is. Though he's been in every single King's. I don't know how long he's been with, but he's been like. He's protected like four kings of Lucis, what I know.
So.
Yeah. Well, they call him Kor the Immortal for some reason. That probably explains it. I have a theory that Kor is actually an astral because he still looks the same as he does when no matter what king he's with, he looks the same.
Try this. Any last words?
Come on. Alright, would you stop that? I can't even get up. I think if you defeat Gilgamesh before 11, I think you get that outfit. I'm not for sure. Looked it up on a bunch of websites. Alright. Oh, it skips to Gilgamesh. Oh no, not yet. That dragon thing. It's called Egadeku. Indeku. Looks like Cutsico though. I really like the music to this though, I'm not gonna lie, the music's just terrific. It's like that, it's all metal. All the soundtrack of episode Gladiolus is metal.
What is your favorite metal bands?
I have several. Slipknot, Lamb of God, let's see, Marduk, Devil Driver, Disturbed, are just the name of a few of them. I also like Avenged Sevenfold, but their earlier work, though. Their earlier work. And Suicide Silence is the last one. Before they started, you know, selling out, of course. Oh, the new Or album was just garbage.
What are you streaming right now?
Mm-hmm.
Vincent, I just pulled the Overwatch in a game with kid I plays. The girl who got 7000 donation on YouTube.
Ain't surprised. Ain't surprised. That's what simps do with their money, they throw it away.
Dang.
The way I see it, simps shouldn't have
no
money.
She said she streams on my free account.
I know you don't talk shit about other streamers, but it's like, her followers are just a bunch of simps that, you know, that's just hoping to get some pussy after spending that much. I gotta say to this good faggot who donated $7,000, good luck paying rent, faggot. Good luck paying rent.
She was getting carried by people 1,000 points ahead of her.
Good luck, because it's like you ain't gonna pay rent from
LOL.
Dudes nowadays, they just throw their money away, hoping, oh, I'm gonna get some pussy if I'm extra nice to this female. It don't work that way. If you're too nice, they'll take advantage of that. And I don't blame them. Shit. If I were a female and thirsty guys were giving me money all the time, I'd use them for everything. I'd even force them to give me their credit card information. And more likely, the sad part is they'll do it. That's the sad part.
That is not ethical, Vincent.
I'm just saying, it's like they kind of bought that on themselves. You simp, you bring it on yourself. You know, I'm sorry, but that's how it works. You could use, see, when you're so easy to use, people are gonna use you. That's why I always say, hey, don't make the female your whole life, dude. Don't do that shit. Don't make a female your whole entire life and your whole entire world. That's just plain unhealthy and stupid. I'm not saying don't date. I'm just saying, you know, don't invest your 100% in all. If I would have done that with Mercy, you know, shit, I probably would have been crushed. That's why I wasn't crushed, because I was smart. I was like, okay, well, that's fine. It's all good. It's all good. You know. In the end, you're just going to throw your life away, and that's just it. To what cost? To what cause? You ain't going to get pussy from this. That's just, if that's what you're thinking. You want pussy, you let the female chase you. That's just a basic, you know, basic economics. And also, it's just natural. Females, you know, females go after the best specimen. That's just the truth. Just don't get try your best not to get yourself friend zoned, because that's what simps do, is friend zone behavior.
Try this.
And then they want to cry, oh, she don't love me, she don't love me. Really? You were too nice. You let her have everything, access to everything. And then you get mad when she, you know, puts dirt out on you on Facebook and stuff. It's like, you gave her it. You know. Like, don't put yourself out there to do that. You know, you're better off not doing that shit. In fact, just stay who you are. If you change for a woman, that it just shows how weak you are.
M.O.G. pouting face.
You know, just stay who you are. Don't change for anybody. If someone tells you you need to change, tell them to suck a fat one. You know? The only reason why bad boys are getting girls is because they refuse to change, and that's the secret. Now, I'm not saying be a bad boy, I'm just saying, you know, stay who you are. Don't let no one change who you are. You know. Because if you let someone change who you are, then, you know, then it's too easy. And they don't like something they can easily get.
Do you think they want the bad boys so they can change them?
That's why they date them. That's the true reason why they date them. Is that they want to get a challenge of trying to change them. But if you change for these, that's the secret. That's the entire secret of why they have their game is stronger than our game. That's the secret they have. Is, you know. And trust me, I know this, because that's why, you know, I get females being interested in me, is because the fact is, I'm a static character. I'm going to stay who I am. I'm my own man, you know, from the day you meet me to even after. You know, I ain't changing for nobody. You know, I don't need to morph my life or my attitudes on for anybody else, you know. But the problem with simps, they'll change. And then they'll turn to the, and then they'll pull a whole, and then Sips will pull a whole John Legend, Usher type of attitude where they'll start singing R&B to them and bringing them flowers, you know, singing R&B and sound like Ice JJ Fish doing it. Don't sound like Ice JJ Fish. I'm about your girl. But that's what happens. That's what Sips turn into. You know, it turned into Ice JJ Fish. You start seeing R&B, bringing flowers.
Man, I love Ice JJ Fish. He is hilarious.
Yeah, well, that's what they end up sound like when they sing to these females. You know.
Also, the girl he uses in his music video is thick as fuck. Oh, you singing R&B over the phone at midnight when people trying to sleep.
Well, he pays a good money. Like, that's how he gets them. But nonetheless, nonetheless, it's like some of these simps come off like Ice JJ Fish. Like I told you about how when Traffelmatic was making that phone call to that girl he liked for 16 years, he was crying on the phone and asking her for her to come back on and singing. I'm like, don't do that, man. Just don't do that. Come on, man. Really? Crying over the phone? Shit. A girl tells me she don't want to be with me no more. I'm like, okay, bye. Nice knowing you. That's what I do. I don't go crying over the phone. That just shows you that. Then they laugh at you. You know that girl probably recorded Travelmatic and probably put all over the internet. Probably recorded that voicemail, put all over the internet. It's just I haven't found it yet. I bet she did, though. Because that's what females will do to you if you cry over the phone and leave stalker voice messages just like, I need you in my life, come back. Just don't do that. Have respect for yourself, man. Respect yourself. You don't need to do that. Don't act like a sucker.
Yeah.
Travel magic is gonna end up on one of those cringe compilations.
I ain't surprised that Darth Vader video ended up being on that cringe compilation video, that one where he talked to the Darth Vader statue. I found it. It was funny. Oh, the comments. Oh my goodness. The comments are just... Someone said that he needed to take his medication.
Can you show us the video?
It's all he has the original video on his channel and he never deleted it. But it's in one of the compilations. I can't remember which compilations, but it's in one of them. So it's actually in the big compilation. It's not just a single video. Oh shit, demon wall. Disgusting piece of shit. What up?
Did you know he dressed like a woman when you were friends with him?
Oh, not much either. Just playing some episode Gladiolus. Score attack. It's really good, actually. I don't know why IG says it's boring. Oh, yeah, I've seen that. This thing will die, okay. There it is, alright. I need to use Mouse Storm on this thing.
Try this. Any last words?
Yeah, I was wondering. It's like, I thought it was like... I piss you off by any chance? Sometimes I do have that effect on people. Okay. That's expensive. Oh, for two. Oh, yeah, so you didn't have a group. This thing is $70 for some reason. Oh, this demon wall won't die. Take another mouse storm to your face. Okay, that should kill Demon Wall.
Any last words?
I haven't got back on there yet. I haven't got back on there. I've been too occupied with Episode Gladiolus ever since I downloaded it. Now I'm just trying to earn all the stuff you get in it. So that's why I'm playing Score Attack. Though Score Attack is harder, though. Cause like, if you run out of potions, you're fucked. Our Mouse Storm. Yeah, I have no choice but to use my Limb Break. I can't fight all these things by myself.
Any last words?
What? There's two more? How is there two more? I just defeated you all. Stay dead, damn it. Shit. Oh. Exactly! Stay... It's like, stay dead! You're dead, okay? There's no way you live through that. There, exactly. You got hit by a pillar. There ain't no way you're living through that.
Okay.
Yeah, die. Thank you. Oh, shit. Okay, I'm gonna be really nervous because the next one I have to face is a red giant. And it's new form, too. Yeah, it gets a new form only in this DLC. Yeah. Okay, wait. Oh, I'm supposed to go back down. Oh, I must have. Okay. Okay, I see it's right down there. Oh, boy. Here we go. Come on out. We know I can see you there. I know you're going to want to come and get me and do some bad stuff to me. I'm going to go ahead and pause this and light up another incense. I'm going to need one. Oh, that thing right there. You don't know half the red giants are worse than the black ones. You know the one, even the one. That's. Yeah, wait till you see their face close up. Oh my god, they have no faces. They have no faces. Yeah, I don't know if you watch Doctor Who, but you know the Weeping Angel? That's the kind of faces these things have. That's exactly what they... Yeah. And this is the worst one to fight right here because I have barely any potions to heal myself. So I'm... Oh yeah, you remember them from Final Fantasy X. They're in any Final Fantasy. Except the red ones are exclusively to 15 for some reason.
Try this!
Yeah, they have them in 10. They have them in 10. They just look different in 10. Because they're in any Final Fantasy. Yeah. They're in... They are in any of the Final Fantasy games. Yeah. Luckily, I'm only have to fight one of these ones here. And then I fight Gilgamesh. I did not even die! What the fuck? I did not even- You saw that shit! Well, pull a fast one on me. I am not starting over if that's the case. I did not even die. What the fuck? No, I didn't even- they give you at least 5 minutes to respond with the Phoenix down. If anything else, I only got hit once and it went low, but it didn't die. I had enough health to put another high potion on me. What the fuck? Well, that's bullshit. I better get something from this. I'm gonna be mad if I got nothing from this deal, other than nothing from Score Attack. Oh, I'm nope. I have to start over. Nope. No, not happening. No, after all that stuff, nah, get out of here. Get out of here with that stuff. I'm not doing it. No. Yeah, return back to title. No, that's nah, I ain't starting over. That's not happening. Especially when Red Giant cheated. That thing cheated. I think I want to play the special. I don't think you see the special, so if you're watching, you might like this one. I'm gonna go to the special, if it's still there. Yeah, I'm gonna do the special now. I'm getting tired. Score Attack. The original episode Gladiolus is fine. I like that, but I don't like Score Attack. Score Attack is bullshit. You seeing me clearly have a little bit of health left. You see me clearly have a little bit of health. You see... Oh, that's right. There's time. Okay, that makes sense. I'm like, I know I didn't die. I know I was down a lot. Like, I only have like 1% health. But nobody... Oh, okay. I'm gonna play the special because I have fun with the special. By the way, you're about to see the guy who's a lot like Seymour in this game. He's in the special. Oh yeah, Arden. Yeah, everybody gets tired of Arden. Arden does the same thing in this game. You know, and the only way to kill Arden is if Noctis sacrificed himself in order to destroy the ring, because he's tied to the Ring of Lucii. The same ring that the kings like to use. Yeah. Exactly. And the worst part, Arden could turn to anybody, so he could turn to anyone and mess your day up. So if he felt like he wanted to fight you as you, well...
Going
Yeah, by the way, Ignis is blind.
Well, there's a way, but I don't see going forward.
Arden did that to him during Altitia.
But now Noctis is facing them alone. There must be some way we can help him.
Perhaps I could be of service.
There he is, that's him.
What are you doing here?
Why, I come bearing gifts.
The hell?
See? Gifts. Now, I believe a thank you is enough.
For what? Another one of your stupid tricks?
Oh, I've seen that.
For a change, but I can see I'm not wanted. I'm loath to trust him.
Take his eyesight. He did a lot of things. Arden just does fucked up shit to people. Yeah, he even kills Lunafreya, which that's the main girl if you didn't know. Yeah. This guy's completely messed up, and he's been actually making the Niflheim Empire and Insomnia fight wars with each other for 3,000 years.
Quit thinking about what you could have done then, and start thinking about what you can.
Yeah, he started because he was mad at his brother because he didn't get the ascent. So, you know, he didn't get the ascent to be the King of Light, so he's mad. He thought the power of the kings, he deserved it, so that's why he's doing all this. Yeah. Oh, I know, spite is all that keeps him going. That's what keeps him going, is spite.
I have a feeling the Chancellor isn't so generous.
How come?
He may have feigned friendship.
I mean, he manipulated the Niflheim Emperor to start wars with Insomnia by using the Niflheim Emperor's greed. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, Arden is twisted. You think that's the worst? At the end of the game, when you get to face him as a final boss, he actually has dead bodies of the Niflheim Empire, King Regis, and Lunafreya and Ravis and Nyx, and at the throne playing with their dead bodies. That's how twisted this dude is. Yeah. No, man, this dude's like, oh my goodness. And if you see his true form, go look up his true form, go look up Arden, Lucius, Kylum, and see his true form. Oh my goodness. Nah, I know which one it is, it's not that one. Yeah, you have to fight. It's a demon, this is a demon. Oh yeah, this whole town's cool. This is the Niflheim Empire that we're at. This is exactly the Niflheim city. It's filled with demons. Mm-hmm. And that's where the Magitek factory is, right up there. Mm-hmm. Here, I can't keep track of the. Okay, now I know where I need to go. I need to go up on the ladder now. I'm in the elevator. But yeah, it used to be a nice town, but then Arden and Eidolus used the Star Scourge and brought it over here and turned their civilians into demons. Because the Star Scourge pretty much infects people and turns them into demons. Yeah, twisted motherfucker. Oh, the evil ones are just twisted. Mm-hmm. They actually compared. Watch Mojo actually compare Arden to Kefka. No, I can see why. They're both a lot alike, except Kefka laughs about what he does. Arden, he'll act like you're a friend, but then he'll fuck your shit up real bad. But they pretty much are both, like, really... Mm-hmm. They'll act like, oh, were you... Keep going a little closer. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Hold up.
Ooh, man. The What's City Arcade would be worse if you had to face both Seymour so and Arden.
Led here by our guide.
Ooh, yeah.
Step in the right direction. I'll take it.
Yeah. Well, of course they're going to. They have to. You gotta have all the iconic characters.
Why do simps give girls money? Watch your step. What do they expect to get?
Which one? The... Old what? Oh, that's not Cosmos at all in Arcade. That's her. No, that her name's Materia. There's a new god and goddesses. Well, no, that's not Chaos. That's actually Spiritus. Chaos is dead now. The time loop was defeated. As long as the time loop's destroyed, Chaos can't respawn himself back in time if you kill him in the past and future. Yeah. So now it's Spiritus.
Did you finish the Ravioli DLC?
Which may help us.
Yes. And it's the same thing with Final Fantasy 1. You had to go back in the past and present and defeat Chaos and Garland at the same time. In order
I fixed my computer. It was overclocked too much.
Yep.
Dang, nice, bud.
Wait,
no, Garland turns into Chaos.
Surveillance tape they forgot to erase.
Yeah, he turns into Chaos. Absorbs all the fiends and then turns into Chaos.
Whatever's on that tape.
So he's actually a part of Chaos.
Sometimes when you spend too much money, you observe glitches in the Matrix.
What? Oh, I want to see this cutscene.
What?
That's the Niflheim Emperor right there.
By the hand of the Oracle, they are with the King.
Oh, he's strong. Watch what he does to Ravis.
And someday soon, he shall use them to purge.
I
want to
see this cutscene with lots of important information. Please do not talk.
Yeah, he's the king
with
of this area.
With great power comes great responsibility.
One true king.
Oh no, he's not. He's not just his father's rival. Yeah. Certainly no, but he's like he's like
this
a rival
Dragon
to
Age
King
Origins
Regis.
DLC.
You are the puppet. And you must die.
What is the name of Noctis Kingdom?
Insomnia. Ooh. Yeah, he ain't nothing to play with. I know this is actually strong. And poor Ravis. By the way, if you wanna know, this ain't Noctis, this is Arden right here. This is Arden right here, if you wanna know.
The gods have shown you their favor. As blood of the Oracle, I present you your father's glaive.
It sucks because this is the first time Ravis actually accepts Noctis.
Slower than the CPU.
But that's this is the first time Ravis accepts Noctis. Mm-hmm.
Dang, you're a computer genius.
And here comes. It's Arden. It's Arden. Watch.
I've indulged your false heroism for far.
And OBS was rendering 3532 fast.
I tried
to
save the world in my stead, but it wasn't enough. The crystal chose me, not you.
See? Mm-hmm.
Aw. Rejection hurts, doesn't it?
Was that not?
Well, he was. No, he got bad fall damage, then added that.
It sounded like Ravus tried to return His Majesty's sword.
Mine is overclocked to 4 gigahertz.
Finally got over his
Vincent,
grudge.
We saw this last time. It was a spoiler.
His king. Well, he's dead for now, but then he comes
back.
Metal
Gear Solid
Guy. Arnon turns his body into a half demon, and you have to end up fighting him in that form.
With the mullet.
Looks like Arnon bought himself some time.
Arnon is really fucked up.
We need to find Noct.
Really? Oh man, a therapist. No, he'd be a therapist's favorite subject. Oh my god, that'd be the funniest. Arnon goes to Dr. Phil.
Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert.
Yeah, what a pent up eating towards your breath.
I'm the
gonna bring out a special guest, the first Caduceus Kylan King.
Looks like some sort of cargo bay.
Ashley asks him, how about that? I heard Spider-Man's Uncle Ben dies.
Not over here. Might be something bad.
That would. Yeah, Dr. Phil would have a hard time trying to convince Arnon, because, man, it'd be the foot. Oh, he don't see it as a problem. He says he deserves to be the king. That's. This is the black ones right there. Well, at least the stronger black ones. Yeah, all the boss.
Yeah, the
platinum demo.
Peter chased down the killer and he fell out of a building and died. But that wasn't his real killer. It was actually.
Right here, Roger.
Yeah, you mean the platinum demo? That's what you're talking about. Yeah. Well, the crazy part of that demo is it don't make sense because. Since all Iron Giants are demons, they're afraid of daytime. They don't show up at daytime. They only show up at nighttime. If it comes daytime, it burns them. That's why the Niflheim Empire is always night. Because that black smoke that they're generating keeps the sunlight out. Because they're afraid of light because it'll burn them. Exactly. Yeah.
We ought to be close to the core of the cube right now.
And that's probably where they're keeping the crystal.
And most likely where Noct is headed as we speak.
Oh, it just makes me go faster. I do that even in Legend of Zelda. Like, I'll roll in Legend of Zelda because it makes me go faster. That's what it does. It just makes you go a little faster. I'm not looking to fight all that. I just want to get through the whole story. I ain't trying to look to fight all those demons. Not in the episodes, only in the real game. You stay level 45 in the game, and in the episodes, because they're DLC episodes.
There it is.
What is it?
The crystal. Right here.
Then we're close.
What?
If it's anything like the Citadel, there should be a barrier barring access.
Until we get to the special one, which you're gonna see this cutscene.
You just tell me what to do.
Right.
Ooh, I remember this part. Yeah, well, they're gonna get rid of those beams so they can go to the crystal. This is why you wanna watch Kingsglaive. The Niflheim Empire took the crystal from Insomnia. Yeah. Because this dude wants it right
Thieves
here.
Cannot escape the hand of justice. The crystal is mine.
That's the Emperor. Transform.
Shall I loose my grip?
Mm-hmm. Oh, just wait. You're gonna have fun with this.
The power. All of it. Mine.
Mm-hmm. That's where the that's what the Emperor turned into.
Dang, you look evil.
Try this.
Exactly. Well, it makes sense, cause he's one of the strongest demons in this game. In fact, he was hard when I fought him as Noctis in the original game. Cause he can do status ailments on you. And damage. Yeah. And then he can disappear and then leave a poison cloud on you so you can get poisoned. Mm-hmm. I think that's probably where they based him off of. Yeah. It used to be connected to 13 when it was first made as versus 13. But they scrapped that, so it's a new universe. But I don't care what anyone says. EOS is still Etro. EOS is still Etro. The goddess, so not the world, the goddess.
Thought Irenaeus that the demons were afraid of the crystal.
To a flame. Or it may be one of the Empire's alternative facts.
Whichever it is, that monster's still on the loose.
We need to find it before it finds Noctocopter.
Did I beat him? Well,
I can see the light fading from your friend's eyes.
Yeah.
Hang in there, Noct.
Yeah, we have to find Noctis because they got separated because Arden pretty much separated us by destroying that train. Hey, Arden has special problems. In fact, I'll probably do the final battle after this. I'll probably go straight to Insomnia and fight Arden. Oh, I can see. Now, he'd be most likely on there because how psychotic he is. Oh, yeah. Oh, he'll just say, no, I'm the king. No, that's what Arden will be like. Oh, I'm the king. I deserve to be king. No. It would be so funny is if someone actually took Donald Trump's speech's voice and put it over Arden. It sounds so similar. Nope, I'm the king. Nope. What are you talking about? Nope. Nope, I'm the king. Nope. You don't get to say that. Nope. I'm king. Nope. The ring's mine. And I don't know what you're talking about. No.
If that son of a bitch even...
Wait. Can't you hear that?
Hear what?
And then he's like, you're not the king. Stop this. No, I'm the king. No. I'm the city king. No. You can't say that. No. Hey, just no. No. You can't. Nope. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah, I'll show you the final. If you're going to watch this a little bit, I'm going to actually go to the final boss fight because I can get there anytime. Because I got the time traveling ability. Mm-hmm. You get that at the end of the game. Mm-hmm. So you can go back and do quests and stuff like that. And some of the episodes do take place in the past as well. Mm-hmm, I did. I even did the secret Piteous dungeon thing that I just... If you ever saw that stream, oh my god, that's the worst place. Now they make... You know what? Come to think of it, now they make it even harder to fly the car now. Like, it's almost impossible to land the car thing. No, I got mad screaming at the top of my lungs. My granny asked what was going on. Yeah, now they make it harder to land the car thing. So they, I guess what it is, they don't want you to go to the PDL's dungeon twice and get the same item. Because now you can get three slots in your parties and you could put pretty much the same thing over and over from your previous game. So they probably made it so, you know, you can't get two black hoods and cheat. Because the black hood makes you dodge attacks. And if you put two on, it'd be pretty much cheap. I think they put a fail safe site. Nope. You can't go back there and do that again. In fact, the Piteous Dungeon was not even supposed to be part of the game. That's the crazy part of that. Yeah, they did that to add more to the game. They did that. Oh, I know. You mean when it was Versus 13? Oh, I know. They added a lot of stuff from Versus 13. All they did was took out Final Fantasy 13 overtones, but it's the same game. They just took out the Final Fantasy 13 overtones. That's all they did. Stella's Luna, pretty much, at this point. They did keep Ravis the way... They did keep Ravis the way he was, because you know the hooded man in Versus 13? That's Ravis. And at one time he... Exactly. Well, he was part of the Niflheim Empire for a while because he wanted to get revenge because he thought it was King Regis's fault that his mom died, and at least in 15. But in Versus 13, Stella dies. Yeah. Now, let's go to the future. This is what the future looks like. This is what happens in the 10 years. After Noctis's stasis. Pretty much, the whole world turns into the complete Star Scourge. So it's darkness every day. Yep, that is. And he could take you to the present or future or any place. Exactly. That'd be pretty cool, man. You know, I'd like to be able to go back in the past to save King Regis from dying and Kingsglaive and fight Glocka. Because the future Noctis would beat Glocka 10 times over. I mean, he ain't that strong anymore, considering what we could see. I mean, even Ravis could take on Glocka like even without an arm. Like, they're like light years beyond Kingsglaive movie. Yeah, Glocka was strong in that movie, but now he'd get beat easily. Yeah, it takes a while to load for some reason because how high the graphics are. Imagine playing this on PlayStation Pro, though. With 4K and everything. Oh, yeah. How'd you get the money for that? I mean, like, that's even more than the original one. That's what I'm asking. That's more. All I got is the original one from a bundle. From, like, an Arkham Knight bundle. Yep. By the way, this is the future. This is what happens to the world. All thanks to Arden.
You've got this.
We're done here.
What's that thing attacking? What's that? Oh yeah, but in the future, that's he pretty much gets the long hair and ends up looking like King Regis. But he's really strong. Like, future Noctis is 50 times stronger than he was in the past. Like, he gets like god abilities. Oh, Prompto, he just grows a beard. That's all what happens to Prompto. Gladiolus gets long hair. And Ignis uses more hair gel, but slicks his hair back. See, this is what everybody looks like now. And all that happens to Pronto is he gets a beard. And he's serious about everything, which... This is why episode Pronto needs to come out. Because it'll show you why Noctis is serious in the future all the time. He isn't like he is in the past. Because if you know... Yeah. His father is actually the Niflheim scientist. And they... Yeah. Exactly. Finding out your half of what this world is. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's why I think Pronto is a huge character develop. People think he's annoying, but I actually like Pronto. Pronto is a good character. On the fact that there's, you know, more about him. By the way, he defeated Ifrit. That's why those red giants are there. But she wasn't that hard of a boss. Though Ifrit's the one who actually trained Arden. Because Ifrit hates humans for some reason. Yeah, this version, Ifrit's evil. In fact, he's the one who actually put the virus inside the volcano. And then made Arden the full Star Scourge. With Arden's consent, of course. They both had the same idea, so they worked together. And then Arden manipulated the Niflheim Empire to go after Insomnia all those years.
Waits outside.
Yeah. And so does Arden.
Acting like he owns the place.
In fact, let me go put the... Let me go put the king stuff on. Because this time... No, that's not what I wanted. Because that ain't going to affect my HP if I put anything on now. See? Yeah. I can do that. Where is the royals? Oh, yeah. He gets a king's glaive one. Wait. Okay, I better not do that to him because his HP will go down, but Noctis's won't. I don't want that to happen. Of course, you don't even need to use it. You don't even use these guys because, you know, Arden puts them in stasis.
It's time to take it all back. It ends here. Tonight.
Yeah, you have to look closely at Pronto. You missed it. Yeah, that's all that happens is he grows a beard, but he still looks somewhat the same. Just looks at his more mature face, which, you know, 10 years later, they're in their 30s.
King Regis the day now, we left.
That was the last time we were in here.
Long time. Watch the Brotherhood anime a long time.
Feels like forever ago. Do the paintings of the prophecy still adorn the walls?
Yeah. Intact and amazing.
We'll witness firsthand whether their story comes true.
Sure it does.
Oh yeah. And that's how they became friends.
Do the paintings of the prophecy?
Yeah. Intact and amazing.
Well, Ignis was sent to kind of raise Noctis because King Regis was too busy. Understandably so, being the king and stuff like that.
Yeah.
That can't be an easy job.
Coming not much farther.
Well,
so you're gonna have to have someone to raise your kid. Especially because I feel sorry for King Regis because he knows his son has to die in order to stop Arden.
Can I see your photos?
Because King Regis in the Omen trailer talked to the crystal, and Arden was on the other side of the crystal. And King Regis asked Arden, how many lives do you need to take this time in order to be satisfied? And Arden says, I'm only looking forward to one.
You can take whichever you like.
And King Regis knew that was his son. You know.
Think of all the places we've been.
Bastard.
All the shops along the way.
Always something new around every corner.
Gotta take one from our zany adventures.
What, this one? Oh, yeah. Oh, the creepiest thing is Shiva in her human form. She can photobomb in all your photos. What? She can be anywhere you're at.
Something catch your eye there,
how many hours have you put into this game?
She's the black haired woman that's with Luna Freya. Mm-hmm. And she's a ghost, so she can go anywhere you're at.
So many photos
she shows up in. It's kind of creepy though, cause like, you know, they like that one, see that one right there. I don't know what photo it'd actually take for me in the final battle. Quite honest. See? There she is right there!
A shot of us in combat might be cool.
Oh my god! Look at this!
Really brings back memories, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You thinking back to when we took that?
Well, she turns into Shiva.
I'm sure it's really hard to settle on just one. Then it's settled. That's the one? No backsies?
Better, you know what? Better than the theories I usually hear. Some people say Gentian, that's her name, is Noctis' mother. Because Noctis' mother died. I know it's not, but Noctis' mom died from the Niflheim Empire attack.
What is that?
Mm-hmm. See, I told you how twisted he gets. Look at those bodies up there. That's what he does to dead bodies.
I'm afraid you're out of luck.
Yeah, I see how twisted this
the
dude is.
Brings you here. It seats only one.
Off my chair, Jester. The king sits there.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, twisted.
Oh, knocked. How I have waited for this.
Longer pretty much, just a torment Noctis.
Tonight. The dreams of the blood.
Except I don't know why Eidolus is in there.
Come to an end.
Spite all that's kept him going.
Talk about a grudge.
Oh, you think? You think? 3,000 years of this stuff? Yeah.
This is my.
I mean, well, I don't. If Final Fantasy had hell, I don't know what the level of hell Arden would be in. I mean,
what did you do?
Yeah, pretty much.
This, the Battle of Kings. Come, Noctis.
He just pretty much knocked him out because he only wants to fight Noctis. Because he has to fight the king and kill the king to take the ring for himself. That's what he.
It ends now.
Oh, it does. I'm way stronger than he is, so I ain't worried. I can beat him really easily.
the once helpless and hapless prince. Is he now ready to claim his crown?
It is. This is what it turns into in the future.
Let us down.
Yep, he's sent the demons to attack it, and sent Diamond Weapon to wipe out everything in King's Lay.
No. Now they end.
Yeah. All because he didn't get to be the king, the ascended king.
How long must I wait?
Yeah. Oh no, when I first played this and got through this, I'm like, holy shit. No, I see why ING, no, I see why Mach Mojo compares him to Kefka. And the crazy part, he's sane when he's doing this. That's the crazy part. That's the most fucked up part. Like, he's sane when he's doing all that. Like, he knows. Homie don't care. Homie, you know. Homie is savaged. Yeah, because he has the same kind of... He's also Lucius Kylian. Well, was. Until he became the Star Scourge. But he didn't get to ascend as king. Only his older brother did, and that's when it got him real mad. Thus, doing he did all this stuff.
A king in name alone. I'm truly disappointed. Can't you do any better than that?
Well, that, and he has the qualifications. The only problem, Arden was strong. The problem with Arden had bits of jealousy and stuff. But pretty much stuff that turned all the Astrals off from giving them the power. They could sense he was a little bit jealous of his older brother, and they're like, this is gonna be bad if we give him this power.
Far from over.
Well, let's have it then. You and your crystal. Against all I have become.
Power of light! Ah, a king at last!
The only reason why Arden's is red because he's also half Orban Bright. Pretty much his mom's a red mage. Or, you know, I think it's his father, something like that. Yeah, it's his father that's a red mage. So his thing turns red. This battle's almost over. I'm way overpowered. Huh? Oh, I see that. I got two other people on my PSN chat during stream.
A war of attrition, then.
Those are the previous kings. They turned into the Knights of the Round Summon. Those are some of the previous
kings. The
kings
of yore are on hand, calling you forth to oblivion.
Yet when your father died, you were off playing with your friends. When your beloved died, you lay watching. Powerless to stop it.
You think 10 years is a long time?
That is how you would end it.
Not anymore. He used to be human, but he became the Star Scourge. Pretty much, he became more the King of Demons. So, that's, you know, he has no... This dude has no heart anymore. I mean, this dude's been doing this for 3,000 years! That's what I said, if there's a hell in Final Fantasy, I don't know what level he would be in.
What will you do? Banish the demons and bring peace? Erase me from history once more?
This time, you can rest in peace.
Exactly.
Close your eyes. Forevermore.
I will await you in the beyond.
Well, there's only one way to kill him, and that's to destroy the ring of Lucius. But only the person who currently has the power of the kings has to kill himself in order for the ring to disappear. So, but since Noctis saved the world, Bahamut gave him the power to do whatever he wants. The only thing is, at the end, yeah, he looks like he's alive. That's just his spirit, pretty much. But Lunafreya comes back alive, and everybody he killed comes back alive. The Star Scourge ends. Because that's the reward he gets for defeating Arden. Because none of the kings could defeat Arden. All they kept doing was all they kept doing was erasing him from history, but didn't know that the ring keeps spawning him back. Mm-hmm. That ring's cursed, pretty much. In short, the ring is cursed. And it's...
So this is farewell.
Exactly.
Here we are.
But in order for him to do that, he has to make a sacrifice.
It's all you.
That's why the... He has to kill himself in order to destroy the ring.
No turning back.
But it's only his physical body that dies. His spirit will live. Because he has the power to do anything he wants now. But only with him sacrificing his life.
Bigness.
That's why King Regis was really pissed at the end of the trailer. Like, you saw his face after Arden says, "I'm only looking for one life."
Walk tall, my friends.
Yeah.
Godspeed. And take care. Majesty.
No, he was 24 in the past timeline. Now he's 36.
The time has come.
No, Arnis. Crazy is Arden's actually related to Noctis. That's the crazy part of that. He's a Lucius Caelium, part Lucius Caelium. His ancestor. Mm-hmm. But an ancestor that turned completely into nothing but evil. Exactly. Just because he couldn't have the power of the king. Mm-hmm. All the demons, the Star Scourge. Remember, Arden is the Star Scourge as well.
I'm home.
So you get rid of him, the darkness will go away, and then anything that's created by the darkness, such as things like demons, they disappear too.
I'm ready now.
Yeah, exactly. It's a chain effect.
I love you all.
Mm-hmm.
Luna. Guys. Dad. The time we had together.
It was. It came from all the generations of the Lucius family. But they didn't know who really crafted the ring. That's why I have a theory that Arden crafted the ring. So he can, you know, keep coming back every time.
Come to me.
And the middle one's Arden's older brother. The one that did the leader. But it must suck for Regis to know that's what was going to happen to his son. Yeah, it's true. Except Regis don't come back because he's a knight around now. Because that's what Regis chose for himself in the afterlife. Yeah. And now he's gonna banish the darkness for good. That knight around is actually King Regis. It don't end there yet. Now, the final task is to banish all the darkness. There it is, the final battle.
I'm about to get Ypres on an FX.
Wait, do you actually beat him in pro?
I'm about to give him as a summoner.
How do you do that? Oh, that's all you gotta do. Yeah, Arden. That's Arden. Right there. Yeah. And you'll see his true form. That's what he looks like. You see that, his eyes? That's what he truly is right there. Goodbye to the darkness now. Yeah, he has to kill all the royal arms too. Yep, that's what his true form looks like. That's what Arden truly looks like, if you're wondering. Exactly. Well, now the darkness is vanished now, because the ring's going to be destroyed. Sorry, I already can't spawn back anymore now.
It's finally over.
The ring's gone. Well, looks like we learned our lesson. Stay away from... Well, Luna knows he becomes spirit form, and plus Luna knew he was gonna die. Well, yeah, which that was a pretty good sacrifice, because, I mean, if you really think about it, because if the darkness exists, everyone's gonna die because the demons are gonna hunt down every single human. Well, Stalin was the last safe place that was in that. Mm-hmm. In fact, that's him right here in spirit form, if you want to know. Mm-hmm.
Dang.
Mm-hmm. He pretty much becomes that. He just has to give up his body to do what he did. Which, you know, a really good sacrifice. We shall all be thankful because the Star Scourge is gone now.
I just...
Well, that'd be pretty much it. The Niflheim Empire is gone now. And both leaders are destroyed. Idolus is destroyed and Arden is. And Ravus, you know, pretty much turned on the Niflheim Empire to give the Sword of Noctis. So, without the High Commander, without the Emperor, and without Chancellor Arden, well, the Niflheim Empire is gone, so... I don't know what they're gonna do with that city, though. That's the thing, though. So I don't know what they do with the city.
I've made my peace.
That's true. Still, that's true, and the darkness is no longer there because the Star Scourge is gone.
And seeing you here now.
That's true. That's true. Maybe there might be some DLC for a future Niflheim territory where you can actually go there.
More than I can take.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, the darkness is gone now.
Yeah. You're damn right it is.
Huh. He spit it out.
Ravus, that was the guy who gave Noctis... That's the guy who gave Noctis that one sword. Well, thought he gave Noctis the sword. He's gone too, cause he's demon too. He's gone too. Idolus. Idolus. Yeah, he's the emperor of the Niflheim Emperor. Oh, he's gone. Like he's completely gone. Arden.
Well.
Arden.
What can I say? Guys.
Mm-hmm.
The best.
Yeah. Well, when Arden became part of the Star Scourge, he altered the ring to do that. Because he knew that all the other kings wouldn't suspect that the ring keeps bringing him back. They think they could just traditionally defeat him. Because, I mean, Arden became part of the Star Scourge, joined up with Ifrit, and Ifrit pretty much transformed into the physical Star Scourge because they both had the mindset. They both wanted revenge against Lelucius Kylium Household. Though Ifrit actually had a good reason, and Arden didn't. Ifrit's mom got killed by all the other Astrals, so I could see why Ifrit turned into what he is. But Arden did this out of jealousy because his brother ascended and not him. And he thought it was unfair because, well, like every mm-hmm, that's the first thing he did. And then it became the Star Scourge. And then started war, then had the Niflheim Empire and Somia have decades of wars with each other. Because Arden's lived for 3,000 years doing this. So 3,000 years of a whole entire nothing but wars between Insomnia and Niflheim. Yes, true.
How many hours have you put into this game?
Yeah. I got the Coleman chairs, it's cool. Advertisement. And there's Insomnia right there.
Dearest Luna.
Mm-hmm, back to the light now. I mean, they're gonna have to fix that window over there, but everything's fine.
To deliver the ring to Noctis.
Well, I'm pretty sure the immigrants in Lestalem will probably come back to Insomnia now.
Though my son may indeed
be. Mm-hmm. It's his wedding.
He has made me proud.
Because even in spirit form, he can still do the normal stuff. He just don't have a body to do it no more.
May you too. No,
mm-hmm. He finally gets married to Luna. Because he had the power to change things, so now Luna's alive. Yeah, I think he probably did that after everything that went on, after the, you know. Who's Blue Wrath? The sad part, her brother doesn't come back. Ravis doesn't come back. That's the only thing about that. Yeah. That's pretty much... He can't. Yeah, he can't. It'd be important. He can't. And it might be a good thing because... You know... I mean, because the only problem with that is... I don't know, but... I guess it's to prevent for another ring like that to be crafted. Because if... I don't know. Something like that. You have to look into the actual lore in this. But, yeah, that ring is really bad. All the kings thought it was a good ring. Oh, no. It kept bringing Arden back. Shit, that's crazy, though. Because you'd think the ring was made by the light, because it was made by the crystal. Pieces of the crystal were actually in that ring. I already have a certificate. I beat the game 3 times. I don't need to have the certificate thing. But I'll save the photos, though. Like, I have the other certificates, too, that I have. Oh, it's not in there? Oh, it'll save automatically, I guess. Ooh, I hate these things. I hate these jalapeno-looking ones. These are the worst giants in the game. Oh, yeah. And they're, like, level 99. Mm-hmm. Load this. I'm still gonna play. Yes, resume playing, please. I'll just save over that file. It don't matter. I beat the game so many times. Because I play New Game Plus. If you beat the game once, you get New Game Plus, you can carry over your items. And everything you earn. Yeah, I'll probably just play a little bit of regular game. What's today, Saturday? Or all Sunday, right? Oh, well, now. Yeah, now today's Sunday. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I just did on my Facebook. But no one reacted, so... It's not funny anymore, because no one reacted. So I was hoping some people would react to it, though. Well, the whole thing was, it was a joke. I said, I got a girl pregnant. Just to see how many reactions I can get. But I guess they knew it because April... come on, it's April 1st. Everyone knows it's April Fool's. Ooh. Oh, that's a little bit morbid. But no one reacted to that thing, so it's like, eh. it's no one reacted, because all it just says I got some female pregnant. I just want to see what reaction I could have got. I mean, I didn't want to go too far because I don't want to have a JonTron situation on my hands, so I didn't want to go too far. I was thinking, should I go there or not? And I'm like, yeah, no, let's not. Let's just not do that. Wait, what is Gladiola's health? HP went back down. I ain't liking it. Oh, they took off the weapons. Fuck. No, don't do that to me. Oh, don't do that to me. I have to put it back in there. Don't do this to me, man. Okay, we'll put the ring Lucii right there. Where's my engine blade? I better have my engine blade. There's going to be some problems if I don't have my engine blade. I'm going to be very pissed off if I don't got my ultimate blade. Okay, good. I better have that shit. And what else do I have? Oh, yeah, I had the... what's his name? Zidane's weapons. The... what is it called? I can't remember what it's called, but, Mage Masters. Oh, they switched him to the suit? That's why I'm getting, that's why my HP is down. Okay, let's look at Prompto. I know Prompto needs to get back to his regular outfit. There it goes. Everyone is back. I think I might keep Noctis, because Noctis don't lose any HP no matter what you put on him. So that's pretty good. I might just keep the King's outfit on him. You can actually wear in the past too if you didn't know that. Yeah. Or should I go fight Ifrit now since Ifrit's available? I think I'll probably fight Ifrit. I think I'll fight Ifrit then go back to the past. Since I beat the game again, I can actually go back and fight previous bosses again. Oh, yeah, that's to go back in the past. It was what you... yeah, I'm gonna go fight Ifrit now just to get some bonus points. Because that's like my favorite boss to fight. Oh yeah, you should see what this version of Ifrit looks like. It looks totally different than the other Ifrits. Mm-hmm.
Ifrit, the Infernian. He doesn't share the Glacian's fondness for mankind. But you can expect a warm welcome. I shall await you above.
Yeah. This is actually my favorite boss of the fight, though. That's Ifrit in this game.
Stay cool. He's gonna bring the heat.
Exactly. Oh, he looks way eviler in this game.
Stay down. We'll keep him busy.
Like a man.
Over here.
He just pretty much put me in danger status.
Here it comes.
Yeah, you want to know? You want to stop, drop, and roll. No fire man can put out this fire. Hey, yeah, he's that big. And that cutscene comes on. Because you don't defeat him. It takes two summons to beat him. Bomb, it comes out of the sky. Here comes Bahamut. Yeah, they changed the summons in this game. They look more human. In this one. They even have actual legit human forms. Comets was stuck in the crystal thanks to Harden, and Noctis frees him after Bomb and gives Noctis his power. Oh yeah, it's badass looking. It does look badass looking. Stop the youngin. Wow. Oh yeah, by the way, that does not defeat Ifrit. That just aggravates him when you do that.
So even that wasn't enough.
It's time for the worst.
Out of the frying pan? Duck, duck, duck!
We need to put this thing out!
I like his music though, that's why I want to fight him. Because I like his music. Yeah. It's actually my favorite song in the soundtrack, Hellfire. Exactly. Yeah, by the way, this is the one who trained Arden, this summon right here. Well, Noctis was trained by Bahamut. Because Ifrit's an evil summon, is an evil astral.
Feels like I'm just taking air, and the flames grow hotter.
Exactly, this.
Stay back so it doesn't kill us!
Move it or lose
it! Well, yeah, he was actually just more of an asshole.
Is there
an equivalent
person to Satan in Final Fantasy?
At 15, he's just pure evil. Cause he uses Alright. Okay.
The flames never stop.
Burning super hot now!
Going out in a blaze. Fight fire with fire.
Alright. Night. Oh man. Okay, he's got a little harder. Oh, what about young Idolus? Yeah. You there? Okay. Okay, I gotta summon Shiva now. Cause it's gonna leave you. Oh yeah, the last. This brings you. Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much that's what Ifrit is. Oh, my chat. I'm just like fighting that boss because of music. No, for real. It's all because of music. And young Idolus. Oh, it's funny. There's probably a good reason why Square Enix didn't make a young version of Idolus. Say?
Told me to bring back the light.
That's our next stop.
On we go.
Can you imagine you'd be like a bodybuilder? You'd be like a bodybuilder. Like on some steroids.
Okay, what's up? What's what am I trying to flex?
Exactly.
Ooh, I'm looking good.
Yeah.
Dude, what is wrong with Idolus?
Now I see why he goes insane. That makes a lot of sense now. He was already that way before.
It's like if Johnny Bravo ever went crazy, he's Johnny Bravo. He's like,
that's why he did what he did. Yeah. I'm saving that photo. Priceless. Ooh. But that, so that's what happened. That's why he went and did all that stuff.
Yeah. He's like, I've got like 3 years of hunt. Pies, I've had enough. Take over the world.
And then he spent the rest of his life doing that. Oh man, you get, that's what, don't put people in the friend zone. That's what happens when you put people in the friend zone. You banish people in the friend zone, they turn into idolists. Ladies out there, don't put people in the friend zone. You do that, it's gonna cause these angry people to make evil empires bent on destroying the world. Don't plummet people into the friend zone. That's a messed up joke. I don't care. And that's how he met Arden, because Arden told him there's a way for him not to get rejected anymore.
He's like, oh shit.
Damn it. Man, it's hard to get that stick to fit in there. I like the way it looks. Looks like my laptop's on fire, but it's not. It's really trippy. Oh man, Noctis looks good. Like this. I see someone at Naka Kong do this version of Noctis. Do the King's, oh man, King's Robe version of Noctis.
How many viewers do you got?
I haven't kept track, because it just, the bar gets there, then it disappears.
Howdy.
So, it'll tell me if it's, like, updated. Because I use the voice chat thing. I mean, I'm gonna be very honest, I really don't like the type thing, because then you don't get to see the game, or the webcam in the game.
What'll it be? What coat do you fancy?
I'm gonna try to change my car. Ooh, I don't like royal green. I can't see it. Champagne gold. Gold! 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 Okay, gold it is. We're gonna do gold! I made that my catchphrase because Brave of Vexus.
How's this?
Y'all gold! Of course, that comes from Austin Powers. That's exactly what that
was. She's all ready for you. Have a look.
Because Gold Member talks about gold like that. So that's where I got that from. Gold! Gold! Oh man, I wish I could find the clip. But that's where I got from. Okay, I might need to spend the night at the hotel.
I have almost all the characters from Final Fantasy.
Wait, from Tactics or Type Zero? Oh, okay.
And gross.
I wonder if you get Emina in that one. Well, she doesn't fight, so she probably won't be in there. Remember, she's a record keeper.
I just have, almost all of them. You know, I'm missing the girl with, like, the short black hair.
Oh, I'm trying to think. Oh, I'm trying to think of class zero. Ooh. Oh, it loaded fast. I didn't even have to load up anything. It just loads fast now. It's cool. I'm playing with my second party, though.
What are you creating?
I'm playing 15 in Evan gets just to see what I get. I play with my second party so I can level up my second party. Cause I wanna level my Garland. Okay, I better play with my old party in that one. I would lose if I do that. Cause my Garland's level 23. And what it is, it's the NES one. There's actually two versions you can get. You get the Dissidia one and the 10 and the Final Fantasy 1 version. Yeah, I'm just gonna play with my regular party while I'm waiting. Let me at least turn some of the volume up. Well, the only two 5-star characters I really have is Kuja and Garland. I know Fang's not a 5-star, but she's still pretty good to get. I think Garland's a 5-star. I mean, he was hard for me to get. The villains are harder to get than the heroes for some reason.
What's RK?
Okay.
Final Fantasy RK.
Oh, it's a place in tactics. It's a place in tactics. It's the world in tactics. Yeah, it's a place in tactics.
Diphilus or Lanu, it's also known as the Thunder God Sid, and is being feared by many for his reputation as undefeated general of the Order of the Southern Sky. So
he's yeah. Ooh, I hate that Curlan. It's like that fat thing with a stitch on its stomach. I hate those things. Even in tactics, those things were nasty. And they're hard to beat. Oh, come on. That should have took them out 10 times over. They don't make sense. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna finish this mission, then I'm gonna get back to 15. What the fuck is that thing? Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, good. I can use my summon. I gotta use my summon, man. I gotta get my summon. Come on, let me summon. Shit, ain't let me summon. I gotta summon immediately. Onyx Dragon. Kuja, use your trance. Okay, those only my main the 5-star characters survived. I'm playing Brave of Exodus while playing Final Fantasy 15, just taking little intermission breaks since I've.
Hey, yes.
Hey.
Okay, that should have killed you.
Just as I don't
have. Yes.
With a ponytail. I know I don't have her.
What does she look like?
She's got a ponytail, black hair, brownish hair.
Brownish hair. What outfit is she wearing? I'm trying to think of.
I don't have shoes.
Is it like the regular Class Zero?
Yeah, it's Deuce. I don't have Deuce.
Oh, I know. Oh my god, I got another one. I could do a summon. I'm gonna do a summon on here. I got enough Lapises. It gave me 100 Lapises for completing that.
Oh, I also don't have size. I want size.
Okay, let me go and do a summon. I think I get a half price summon. So I'm gonna go ahead and do a half price, see what I get. Gold! If it's gold, it's some good. Oh, another tactics character. I should have known. Alargnus. She's in tactics. You get her in the beginning of the game. Oh, Well, if that's the case, I can't say gold. Alright. Let's go ahead and get rid of those. No, I don't have enough for that. Where's the red? What do you do with the red ones? I got red orbs now. Oh, maybe it's right here. No. Okay, I have enough Ifrit coins to summon a Final Fantasy XIV character. That's it? That's all I get for 400? That's stupid. That's some bull. Oh, maybe it's Arena Summon. No, where could I use the red ones from? Tactics? No, they don't do it. Well, then what's the red orbs for? What do you do with the red orbs? You sell for cash? I don't know. I'm gonna go buy me some enhancement, though, because I want to enhance my Garland. Shit. I can't do that. There's a reason why. Okay, I got gifts. Someone gave me some gifts. Receive, receive, receive. Here, receive all. Request. Okay, I can't. Oh, you can actually send a Facebook invite. I'm gonna go ahead and do that, get people hooked on the game. You know, you gotta get people hooked on them gateway drugs. I shouldn't say. Okay, did I do anything? Let's see. I hope I didn't erase my game. I'm gonna be so mad if I erased my game. What? No. No. Please, this is a joke. Oh, fuck. No. Oh my God. What happened? Oh. Please don't tell me I erased my game. Oh, I should have done that. Oh, I accidentally erased the game. Oh. Okay, I better get some rare stuff then if that's the case. All them raids and everything I did is for nothing.
You lost all the progress.
Oh, you think? Oh, man. Okay, I'm gonna have to go through rare summon. Please summon something good. I have to start my game all over just because I did that in fight. Oh, I got my Garland back! Oh my God, okay! Alright, I'm not too mad. I'm okay. Everything's gonna be alright. I got Garland back. And I got 8 tick rare ticket summons, so let's see what we get. What if I get Cloud? Oh, I got Cloud of Darkness? Okay, I'm getting better characters than I did in the last game. I mean, more rare characters than I did in the last game. Maybe it's a good thing I erased my game. I got Hope. Let's do it again. I like this rare ticket summon. Let's see what we get with this one. I want to make my party right away. I got 8 from type 0. Maybe it was a good thing I did erase my game. I'm getting better characters. Like, I mean, I got better characters. I mean, I'm mad because my Kuja was at max level. I don't know who Leo is. Please give me a Cloud or Sephiroth or Noctis. Maybe a Noctis. Raphia, I guess she's. I don't know who that is. Well, I got better characters than I did in the last game. So it's not all bad, but I'm still mad. All that progress for nothing. Like, for nothing. I have to start all over. Shit, that makes me mad. Level 2 again. That's fine, but at least I got me Cloud of Darkness and I got Garland back. So it's not all bad. We'll put her in there. Oh, I can't believe I erased my game. I'm so angry. I better check my Facebook to make sure it's not messed up either. Well, I'm gonna stop playing since I'm pretty mad. I lost all that progress for nothing. Nothing. Shit. Well, lost my progress there. Let me see if it messed up my Facebook. Because it messed up my games. And I shared it. I shared it on Facebook. Who's someone I actually like my fan art? Someone actually like my fan art.
Of what?
Lucretia. Mm-hmm. You know the one I have on my wallpaper?
Oh yeah.
Someone actually liked it. It's just a new take on her. Like a more modern take.
Oh shit.
Mm-hmm. Ignis, alright, let's see. I can't go to the Pityos dungeon. I don't want you to go twice. Now I see. Should I do the missions and castle work?
This guy has Mateus as one of his characters.
I lost my Kuja! I'm so mad! And my Golbez. Let's start over. Shit. Fucking pricks.
How did you accidentally delete your profile?
Apparently when you share it, it resets everything. And I didn't know that. Like when you make an invite, like if you invite more people to play the game on Facebook, you pretty much just... it overrided. Yeah. Yeah, this is exactly why I stopped playing Pokemon Go.
Yeah, I just stopped playing because they deleted my account for whatever reason.
Yeah. Well, mobile games have more plus to do.
Plus, the game was kind of dying, in my opinion.
It was. People were trying to bring it back. Exactly. They didn't. I don't even think they had a trade, did they?
No, they never came out with trade. Or even battling.
Yeah, so. I mean, they came with the Johto, but woohoo. It's like the game's already dying. The game was already dying off. It was good when it first came out, because it gave people something to do, but then. They kept giving us shit Pokemon, first of all. And they kept. Then you know. Then they delete your thing, and then no trade. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and go through the challenge. The Crestorn Challenge one, the longest dungeon. Of course, I ain't gonna start it yet. Because it's going to be, I think it's May 5th or, it's either May 5th or May 8th if they don't push it back. Episode Prompto comes out. Oh, in June, so it's going to be far away.
Yeah, like
the end of June. Oh, then I might as well just go ahead and complete the Crestorn Challenge Secret Door. Because that's the longest Secret Door quest. And then the
DLC comes out with the Ignis.
Well, of course they're gonna make the Ignis in this one, because it's gonna be about the bros. And then I know there's an Arden one that goes on Arden's past.
This area is swarming with bugs.
Yeah.
And I think that part that that update patch. I think that was episode Ravis, a little bit. I think that was that they're gonna do for that. Of course, this sucks because like I know what happens to him before that because I read that fan comic. I still gotta show you the fan comic because I reviewed it. Well, it's not a fan comic. My bad. It's actually a comic by Square Enix because Square Enix is starting to do comics. Just to explain backstories on their games. But what's supposed to happen before the Magitek Factory, Ravis bumps into Aranea, and Aranea gives Ravis a pep talk. Because Ravis is depressed now, because he lost Luna Freya. That's why Ravis changes and, you know, it starts to accept Noctis. But it was all Aranea's help, of course, because she's the one who told him to tough it up, of course. The only thing about that real comic, this is what made Square Enix, but the only thing about that comic is now people are going to try to ship Aranea with Ravis. That's the only thing about that. Oh, okay, I'll have to stop right here. I don't think I can get into the thing yet. I'm gonna go ahead and stop the broadcast here. Now I only have one viewer.